Stephanie, some of you may not, but she's just going to share a little bit of her story, kind of what she's been involved in, right, in the past year or so, but this started a little while ago, right, longer? Or...
Right, so my husband and I became foster parents last March, and I'd say we started the official process in November, and then I'm trying to think, it was summertime-ish when God really just like placed that call in my heart.
Yeah. Yeah, so what was that journey like for foster care? Like, what does that look like for you to become a foster care parent? What kind of things did you have to do to start that journey?
So we went to a free informational meeting, and it was held at the office in Española, and it was just Mike and I and another couple there. And at this point, Mike hadn't necessarily said, like, I'm 100%, but we had been talking about it, and it just, my passion for it just kind of grew, and I know God was working on his heart, and I honestly believe that it was when we were there, and when the worker there had told us the numbers of children who are in our community here, and it's so hard to hear how many children just in your very own backyard need a home and just someone to love on them. And I think it was like 84 children, and there were I know there were some foster families that were relative families. And my husband asked, well, how many non-relative foster families do you have for these kids? And at the time, she said 10. Mm-hmm. And I think it was at that point that my husband became on board.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he saw the need, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and you had a little boy with you recently for a while.
Yes.
Yeah, how long did you have him with you?
We had him for 11 months and 10 days. And, yeah, he was our baby. We called him Miguelito, little Michael, because we already had two Mikes and Michaels in our house, and my children are masters of nicknames, and so my four-year-old at first was calling him Baby Fosters, and then he graduated from Baby Fosters to Miguelito.
What would you say is the most rewarding thing about being in the foster care system, starting this journey?
Oh my gosh, there's probably a lot, but, I'm going to try to say it without crying, seeing my children, love on these babies has been by far the biggest blessing. I mean, they have welcomed every child into our home, and just, they love on them, they annoy them, they hate on them just as if these children are another brother. We've only had boys, so I say brother, so.
Yeah. If some of the ladies, if they're interested, how could they find out more about maybe getting involved in this as well?
So I'd be happy to talk to you, share anything, any questions you have. But I also brought a friend, and her name is Rachel. She works for CYFD, and she is one of the many reasons that, like, our journey this past year was amazing. You know, when you start researching foster care and you start thinking about, like, whether or not this is something that you want to do, sometimes you read, like, all of the scary stuff because people put, like, their bad experiences out there online, and a lot of people haven't had, like, an excellent experience with CYFD, and that was one of the ways that God just blessed our family was we had two caseworkers, our placement worker, and then Miguelito's placement worker, and they were both amazing. I mean, just amazing. And so anyways, I brought one of them with me, and I love her, and I love how well she supported our family, and she has information if you guys have any questions.
Thank you so much, Stephanie, for sharing with us. It's incredible to open up your home to a stranger. Like, really, right, to do that. It's a big deal to invest in the youth. And like I said, Diana earlier, she's investing. So, Diana, if you would come back up one more time. We do have a gift that we want to give both of you. Just to say, because tonight really is talking about what you're doing, but we're celebrating strong women.
Yeah.
And you are both strong women.
Yeah.
And we see you. We value you. We appreciate all that you you. I'll take the mic, please. But we're just so thankful that we have women in our community that are pouring into others. And so, like, honestly, like, I know sometimes there's things that are unappreciated, and sometimes it's hard. These things are hard, and life and doing these things, stepping out is challenging. But we are so appreciative of the strong women that you are, and we love you so much. So thank you, ladies.